The questions have to be asked, the answers have to be demanded. The third theory, which is a theory which is now a very legitimate theory because of unveiling of two sub-theories. The first is that this Gumnami Baba had a similar handwriting, similar color, similar height, which is 5'10". Subhash Chandra Bose was a heighted person. He was extremely fair. He had spectacles. He used to use pipes. He had Rolex watches. He was an ex-ICS officer, so he knew what rich things were. And this Gumnami Baba in Faizabad, who died in Faizabad in 1985, his belongings, when they were searched for, there were Time magazines, there were hundreds of books in English and Bengali. And this Baba was living in the areas of Bastar, you know, Faizabad, Ayodhya, and regions where, you know, if you find the Time magazine in that period, police would definitely inquire you that you are some CIS stoop or something like that. Because 1985 was something or some period when we were leaning for USSR's side. So you would be a CIA agent if you had Time magazine or Reader's Digest and stuff like that. But these belongings, along with the photographs of Netaji's parents, were found in the belongings of this Gumnami Baba. But the DNA, which were supposedly the teeth of that Gumnami Baba, did not match with the family of Subhash Chandra Bose. My personal belief is, if the government can stoop so low that it has to spy on different family members of Netaji, it can definitely alter the DNA reports. I think I am making a huge allegation here, but if everything else matches and DNA does not match, and DNA reports are brought from the government laboratories, because we don't have private DNA sanctioned laboratories as of now in India. We have it now, but there were no laboratories then. There's a second sub-theory which makes a much more noise. I know it's not very believable, but just think about it. The second theory is that in 1986, Lalita Bose, who was the daughter of a brother of Subhash Chandra Bose, I think it was Sharad Chandra Bose, but I don't know for sure which brother, because there are three siblings for Subhash Chandra Bose. The names of these siblings are, and let me refer it to them. Okay, there was Sharad Bose, there was Suresh Bose, there was Tirumala Bose, and then it was Subhash Chandra Bose. So the daughter of Suresh Bose, Mrs. Lalita Bose, filed a case for investigation in 1985-86. The judgment came in 2013. But it is said that because this case will make much noise, someone from the Congress filed a PIL in the SC at the same time, when there was absolutely no necessity for that, to open the doors of Ram temple. So it is said by some people, and I am just picking up theories here, but it is said to just suppress the noise which would be made by this case, or the findings of this Gumnami Baba and his belongings, which were so apparently matching to someone who was Subhash Chandra Bose. Ram Mandir case was brought up, which has rattled the history, and then Rath Yatra and so on and so forth. So today we will leave with a lot of questions, but do not forget to subscribe, share and like our videos. And one more announcement is that we are going to start a current affairs section very much soon, which will be called Breaking It Down. They will be more shorter videos, more crisp, more visuals in that. So please do watch those videos too. Thank you so much. We'll be meeting next Thursday. Namaste everyone. After the first successful season of Bharat Bhagyavrata, we're also looking forward to the next season of Into Perspective. But for that, we are also looking for title sponsors and associate sponsors. If you know anyone who is willing to sponsor for an informative cause, please do recommend them our videos and our channel. We will be glad to accept their title sponsorships. Thank you.